Praise the Lord. I believe you are doing very well in the name of Jesus. This morning, this afternoon, this evening, I want to share with you the word of God I have entitled, There is Power in the Name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Turn your Bibles with me, if you please, to the book of Acts chapter 3. Reading from verses 1 through to verses 7. Bible says, Now Peter and John went up together to the temple at the hour to pray on the ninth hour. And a certain lame man from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which was called Beautiful, to ask alms from those who entered the temple. Seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked for alms, and fixing his eyes on them, he looked at Peter and John. So they gave them his attention, expecting to receive something from them. Then Peter said, Silver or gold I do not have, but what I have I give unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Hallelujah. And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up immediately, and his feet and his ankles received strength. So he, leaping up, stood, walked, and entered into the temple, walking, leaping, and praising God. Hallelujah. There is power in the name of Jesus. Bible says in Acts chapter 3, that there was a man from her mother's womb. He has suffered for so long. He always sat at the gate called Beautiful, begging for alms from the people who entered the temple. But beloved, one day the name of Jesus spoke on his behalf. Bible says that when Peter and John got to the temple, the man was expecting to receive something from him. The Bible says, Peter and John said to him, Silver or gold we do not have, but what they had was Jesus Christ. Beloved, today there is power in the name of Jesus. What are you going through? What has been something that has been on your heart? What burdens you so much that when you go to bed you cannot sleep? Beloved, tonight there is power in the name of Jesus. Bible says that immediately his feet and bones received strength. I pray that this afternoon, wherever you are listening to me, receive the power, receive the grace that is in our Lord Jesus Christ to do exploits in Jesus' mighty name. When you read verses 7, Acts chapter 3, verses 7, and Bible says he took him by the hand and lifted him up immediately, and immediately he received power. Tonight, I pray that may the Lord fill you up. May the power which is in Jesus Christ fill you and grant you the ability to do the things that you are not able to do. When you read verses 8 of it, Acts chapter 3 verse 8, Bible says, So he was leaping, jumping, and praising God. Today, the 1st of April 2016, You are about to jump for joy. You are about to leap for joy. You are about to praise God because there is power in the name of Jesus. I pray that may the Lord fill you up and maybe make you acknowledge that whatever you are going through, it is just for a matter of time. Bible says in Matthew chapter 4 verses 4, this is when the enemy went to tempt Jesus Christ after he has fasted for 40 days and 40 nights. Bible says that Satan asked Jesus to turn the stones into bread. But Jesus stood upon the word and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but upon every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Beloved, how much of the word do you have in you that when the enemy arises against you, you can be able to withstand him? I beseech you that may the word of God dwell in you richly, that wherever you face any trial, wherever you face any temptation, because Jesus conquered, may you also be a conqueror. Bible also says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 17 that you and I, we should pray constantly, because the enemy is afraid of a prayer warrior. He's afraid of someone who prays. Beloved, a prayerless Christian is a powerless Christian. For the name of the Lord to fight on your behalf, you have to wake up at dawn and pray. You have to wake up from your sleep and pray. Because he is roaring like a wounded lion, seeking for you and I to be born. But tonight may the Lord fill you up. This morning may the Lord fill you up. This dawn, this afternoon, wherever you are, may the Lord fill you up. Even as he filled the man who stood at a temple gate called Beautiful. When the hour came for his restoration, he received his healing. I pray that if any member of your family is going through temptation, if there's a burden too high for you to carry, tonight may Jesus Christ of Nazareth, may he heal your water and may he heal your land. As I come your way once again, I pray and I hope that today's encounter will change somebody's story. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord keep you. May he lift you up from grass to grace. May he make you a hero, even as he delivers you from the plots of the evil one. Be blessed, and may the Lord continue to supply your riches. And may he continue to make you the head and never the tail. In Jesus' mighty name. My name is Samuel Osu Anson Yeboah, and I would like you to subscribe to this channel, share this message, even as the Lord continues to lift you up from zero to hero. May God bless you in Jesus' name. Shalom.